We all know modern business is built on data, but where do we store that information? How do we get that information in everyday use within our organization? Let me show you what that looks like. So usually after the little crumbly Rethink Revenue logo, we get into some kind of presentation, some kind of interesting, entertaining video where we go through a process of something cool and we teach you something about the way a platform works or the way a piece of software works or the way business is done. In this case, we want to answer what is CRM from your perspective. It's really important that you understand what we're talking about from a macro level at your business. To start out with, we are Rethink Revenue. We discover, disrupt, and rethink the way business is done today. I go into a lot of detail on what we do on LinkedIn, so you should reach out and connect with us. You can see right here, I consider myself a CRM authority. We put a multitude of videos out there on different perspectives on business, social media, software. There's a lot of different items that Rethink Revenue encompasses, so subscribe there for more information. And then finally on Facebook, we add those videos from YouTube to our Facebook channel, and very slowly but surely we're growing our subscribers so the Facebook platform can be leveraged. This is how we view all business. It's called zero point selling. The methodology is locating people we want to sell to and transitioning them from unknown to known, known to liked, and then finally liked to trusted. From a macro level, this is the way we view buyer's journeys and seller's journeys. As marketing is applied to people, they start to understand who and what a business is. They start to see how benefits are affecting customers of companies. They start to understand what the process is to get a deliverable, a product or service. We label these inside software tools so that we can control the vocabulary within our businesses and we can start to identify, start to pinpoint where we're failing and where we can do better. So the idea here is to understand what a target is, understand what a suspect is, a prospect, and then finally what a customer really is. We use tactics on different platforms to create leads, to get them qualified by our sales staff, and then ultimately bring them to a client perspective where we can remarket to them. That's everything that Rethink Revenue does. That is zero point selling, a data-driven strategy to execute tactics on potential customers, transitioning them into actual customers. I know there were some buzzwords in there, but bear with me. Typically, companies think of their business on the deliverable side. What happened after a customer got our product or service? Because that's the truth, because CRM isn't really recognized as something that controls the product side, the service side of things, we're gonna start where you believe your business works. Now, the idea here is that we workflow from start to finish, from the customer journey framework, very beginning of the targeting, all the way through the sales process, all the way through the deliverable associated with a product or service, until a customer is fully satisfied, until you can start remarketing to them. In the beginning, it's, hey, do you know about this thing that we do for other people that they really like? In the end, it's, we hope that we delivered the thing, the product, the service that we advertised in a way that you're enjoying it. Let's have a conversation about how we can do more with you. That's the entire workflow here. We're gonna go through it area by area very quickly so you start to understand the part, the activities, the responsibilities, and the general role players in a way that brings a target to a satisfied customer. Typically, we think of a sequence of events that leads a target through to a purchase, right? Your deliverables in here. I use this as an example of the way a production process works, a service deliverability. Before that, CRM's operating. After CRM, you've got accounting software, inventory management, and ERP, if you're familiar with enterprise resource planning software. We're not going to go into that today because it's a way bigger discussion. But overall, we understand the interoperability of these softwares with one another as they are tools in an organization. So now that we've kind of gone through what the production into things looks like, let's take these familiar terms and project them into sales process. Now, a number of you out there are going to understand the part, the activities, the responsibilities, and the general role players in your organization from a sales perspective. And you're also going to recognize what a sales process is, a series, a sequence of stages and tasks that lead to a deliverable. So in this case, you've got steps 5 through 14 that we've outlined. When we zoom out, you can see there's some commonality in the production area where you're looking upstream to figure out what is going to have to happen on a deliverable. I'm not going to get into that sequence. That's continuous improvement from a manufacturing perspective. But what I do want is everybody to understand a sales process, like a Carnegie sales process or a Sandler sales process, is steps to get from one psychological milestone to another with a customer, a buyer. As the seller, you want to guide that journey so you can get a predictable, scalable outcome. This is opportunity for deal management within the CRM tool. Where your proposal gets signed is the transition between sales and production. The software that handles that is CRM. This is where contacts are associated with accounts that are associated with communications, different marketing channels, email addresses, LinkedIn profiles, Facebook profiles. All of these are stored in CRM so that you can communicate with your customers, so you can reach them to give them more information about the benefit of your organization and the value proposition that they should know about. Working backwards, we start with marketing. And this is so far away from the production end of things that most organizations really struggle identifying what marketing should be. In zero-point selling, we've identified a sequence of events in marketing that leads to an accountable destination that is a lead developed to be qualified. We've all heard this conversation. Marketing sucks. They give us the worst leads. On the other side of it, marketing says, sales, you guys are terrible at your jobs. You can't close these deals that we're bringing in for you. And there's this tension that constantly vacillates between this point of accountability. Well, what we've done is we've created a way to identify what marketing should be and strategically approach this so that when a lead is delivered, it's a little bit better than it was before. And we can start to add some commonality, a relationship between marketing and sales. This is what CRM is used for. This is the why behind CRM. I realize I'm not into the details of a CRM. I'm not giving you where you go on HubSpot and you fill this data point. Like, that is something from the product sales side of things. That's on your implementation team. What I'm doing is saying, put data in a system so that you can identify a perfect prospect list, create a marketing campaign, track the engagement, and deliver leads to the sales department. That brings you into a sales process that's guided through CRM. Once you get to a signed proposal, your production kicks in, and then source of truth changes to where the most important work is getting done, that accounting for profitability measure, that inventory management, that cost control in ERP can be created and automated, hopefully. So overall, this macro level perspective on what is CRM is placed right here. Marketing and sales are guiding a proposal signature that production can deliver. If you don't understand CRM like this, take a look at Zero Point Selling. Reach out to us on these platforms. We want to hear from you on LinkedIn. Connect with us. Reach out to us and subscribe on YouTube to learn more about it. If you want to set a sales record and modernize your business at the same time, come have a conversation with Rethink Revenue, where we discover, disrupt, and rethink the way business is done today. I'm Mark Perrone. Good fortune.